Renaissance.
Well, the problem with Renaissance and most Baroque music, for the lute in particular, is we don't have expression marks, we don't have dynamics, we don't have rallentando, adagio, accelerando. These are all more 19th century terms. So you're quite right, we have to make our own interpretation of the music. And what's important is to examine the type of repertoire you're playing. For instance, if it's a prelude or an improvisatory piece, of which there are many for the lute, some of them are called tastar de corde, or prelude, or entrée de lute. These tend to be free pieces that can have a flexibility of rhythm. So for instance, the Dowland preludium I played earlier, I wouldn't dream of playing it in a four square way. I would play it in a slightly free way.
I know it's hard for you to do, but can you play that?
I play it strictly straight. Vertically. Bit soulless.
So it's rubato, really, isn't it?
Rubato, absolutely. Whereas if I'm playing a dance piece, I'd want it to have a very strict pulse. But what's very important for me, and I think a general approach to Renaissance music, would be when the music goes up.